Ciao, I'm Federica Serra, Italian teacher from speakinitalian.com. Bravo! Are you sure that you pronounce this Italian word correctly? And are you sure that you use this Italian word in the correct way? Let's talk about this. Heard many English speakers using this Italian word, and I've heard it being used in many movies.
Bravo!
But do we Italians really pronounce it bravo? And do we really use it indistinctly for any type of situations? You're going to discover this in this video. Sei pronto? Iniziamo! Before getting started, hit the subscribe button, click the notifications bell, and don't forget to follow us on Facebook. Eccoci qui, carissimi English speakers! I don't mean to let you down with this video, but the correct pronunciation of bravo is bravo, bravo. And we use bravo only when referring to a masculine singular noun. Like Marco è un bravo ragazzo. Bravo Marco! Carlo è un bravo dottore. Bravo Carlo! Luca ha preso 10 in matematica. Bravo Luca! When referring to a feminine singular noun, bravo becomes brava, but the feminine, brava. Laura è una brava ragazza. Brava Laura. Maria ha pulito tutta la casa. Brava Maria. Brava Sara, ce l'hai fatta!
And does it change for plural nouns? Yes, it does change for plural nouns. And it becomes bravi. Unless the group of plural nouns is formed by female gender only, so it becomes brave. To give you an example, le mie sorelle sono brave. Brave ragazze! Maria, Sara e Laura hanno fatto tutti i compiti. Brave! Sara, Laura e Maria hanno vinto la partita. Brave ragazze! And what if you want to emphasize it? Well, if you want to emphasize, bravo becomes bravissimo. Brava becomes bravissima. Bravi becomes bravissimi. And brave becomes bravissime. Marco è un bravissimo cantante. Laura è bravissima in matematica, ha preso 10. I miei vicini di casa sono bravissimi, hanno pulito tutto il vicinato. And now let's take this Italian adjective to the next level. Let's see the Italian expression essere bravo a, literally to be good at. Well, we use this expression to say what we are good at doing. Like, io sono brava a cucinare. Tu sei bravo a parlare l'italiano. And if you are female, tu sei brava a parlare l'italiano. Careful when using this Italian expression because afterwards it needs the verb at its infinitive form. You use the ing verb instead. Well, I remind you that an infinitive verb in Italian ends in are, ere or ire, like mangiare, bere, dormire, andare, vedere, partire, and so on. The very last thing you have to remember is that when the verb afterwards begins with a vowel, a becomes ad, like in these examples. Io sono brava ad urlare. Tu sei bravo ad elaborare dati. Lei è brava ad andare in bici. I give you now the last two examples so you better see the differences between a and ad. Io sono brava a parlare. I've used a here because the verb begins with a consonant, p. Io sono brava ad ascoltare. This time I've used ad because ascoltare begins with the vowel A. So this is it. It is easy, isn't it? Benissimo! And now it's your turn to use it. Let me know in the comments below the answer to this Italian question. Cosa sei bravo a fare? Cosa sei bravo a fare? Give me as many answers as you want. I'm curious to read them. And I promise I will reply back. If you liked my video, give me a thumb up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And click the notifications button till it looks like this so you get a notification every time I put online a new video. And don't forget to share this with your friends. Grazie per essere stato con me. Ci vediamo nel prossimo video. Ti auguro buona giornata. Ciao! Non mi sa che lo rifaccio comunque sia. Per sicurezza. Per sicurezza! Per sicurezza! Let me know in the comments below. Che cos'è questo rumore?
If you want to practice your Italian with me, feel free to contact me to my email that you find in the description below. I'll answer you as soon as possible to decide together what time is the most suitable for you to have the private individual lesson. Thank you so much! The next step is to download my free ebook, Guide to the Typical Situations, which helps you master your Italian in those typical situations you will surely find yourself once in your life. Remember to subscribe to my channel for more free lessons. Thanks so much for learning with me. Ciao!